Hello, my name is David Kingston. I'm a professor of chemistry at Virginia Tech, and I do research in bioorganic and natural products chemistry with a particular focus on the discovery of anti-cancer agents and anti-malarial agents. I work in Madagascar as part of an international cooperative biodiversity group there, receiving funding from NCAM as well as other components of NIH. I'm also looking for anti-malarial compounds in a separate project funded by NCAM. And it's a privilege to be funded by NCAM. I'm also a member of NCAM's advisory council since June of 2011.
What do you see as the future of natural products research?
Well, I see the future as very bright. Natural products research, really, if you look into history, has contributed enormously to drug discovery. Over 40% of anti-cancer drugs owe their origin to natural products. 35% of all drugs come from nature in one form or another. And so just based on that history, I see the future of natural products as being still very, very good in terms of providing new drugs and new drug leads.
What are some of the major obstacles that need to be addressed to allow for more progress in natural products research?
Well, I think there are a number of issues we need to address. One is the whole issue of tighter integration between chemists and biologists, doing better chemistry and better biology to bear on natural products research. So, for example, we have chemists who are very good at isolating compounds, but sometimes the compounds they isolate aren't as useful as they might be because they haven't worked closely with biologists. So I see a tighter integration of chemistry and biology. I would like to see more innovative biology brought to bear on natural products research, new biological targets, for example, looking for protein-protein interactions or looking for very specific mechanisms using perhaps new assays that even haven't been developed yet. Because biology is now such a powerful tool that there's so much more that we brought to bear on natural products research. At the same time, I'd like to see improvements, obviously, in chemistry, in structure elucidation methods, in purification methods, so there's a lot that can be brought to bear that would actually really facilitate new drugs from nature, and also improved understanding of ethnomedical products, improved understanding of herbal products.
Why should the NIH be invested in this when it seems like the pharmaceutical industry is moving away from this field?
Well, one reason is because the pharmaceutical industry is moving away, which we can talk about later, NIH is one of the few remaining players that is able to fund and willing to fund this type of work. So I think it's really crucial if we're going to keep discovering new drugs, new cures for cancer, new cures for malaria. If we're going to keep discovering those drugs, we need the input of natural products, and NIH is really the big player in that game, and we need NIH support.
Why is industry moving away?
That's a good question, and there are a number of answers to that. One is the fact that natural products was seen under an old model as being relatively slow and inefficient. And that doesn't fit well with the current paradigm of drug discovery in industry, which has a focus on high-throughput screening, high-throughput synthesis using combinatorial chemistry methods. And that paradigm has cost millions and millions of dollars and really hasn't yielded that enough success to justify that expenditure. But because of those huge expenditures, most of the pharmaceutical industry decided to pull out of natural products, redirect those resources into CombiChem, high-throughput screening, and so on. I think they may regret that in the future, but that's the reality as it is today.
There's technologies that are available now that will address some of the slowness or the challenges that the field has faced in the past?
Yes, I think there are. One technology I'm a big fan of is the idea of working with natural products, not as crude extracts, which was the model of the past, but to work with natural products as either purified fractions, where you take a crude extract and partition it into 10, 20 fractions, and then test those. And they are that gives you gets rid of nuisance compounds, and it also focuses interest on maybe small compounds, small amounts of compounds, minor constituents that are nevertheless very active compounds. So that's one approach. The other approach is the use of new assays. Again, I'm a big fan of phenotypic assays that work well with natural products and can, with the appropriate design of the phenotypic assays, they can lead you to really good mechanistic understanding as well as to just to active compounds.
Can you say a few words about how natural products research can provide insights into fundamental biology?
Natural products have really been important in discovering new mechanisms of action of biological compounds. One example I'm very familiar with is Taxol. It was a natural product. It was isolated as a cytotoxic agent in the 1970s. In 1979, Susan Horwitz discovered it was a promoter of tubulin polymerization, which was a completely unknown mechanism at that time. Nobody had discovered anything that did that in the past. And once Taxol was found to have that effect, and that was its primary mechanism of action, people then began looking for other compounds with that mechanism. The apothelones came out of that study and other clinical compounds. So Taxol has not just been a drug, but it's been the lead to finding other drugs from other sources. And there are other examples of that, but that's the one I'm most familiar with.
What would you say are the two or three most important ways that NIH can have an impact in natural products research?
Well, obviously, NIH is hugely important in terms of funding. So clearly funding natural product research. I think focusing that funding on new mechanisms, on perhaps new sources of natural products. We have just barely begun to scratch the surface, for example, of endophytes, of bacterial symbionts, of marine organisms, and so on. There's a lot of potential in new organisms, new sources of natural products. So some focus, some interest in those areas. New bioassays, if NIH could fund new phenotypic assays that were mechanism-based, so you could grow a particular kind of cell, for example, and not only find inhibitor, but also find out what its mechanism of action was by use of a number of these kinds of assays. That would be research, I think, be very valuable to the natural products community, as well as to the wider chemical community and drug discovery community. So those are just two ways I think NIH could certainly assist in natural products drug discovery.